to speak on behalf of the largest single party in this place. And may I say that if I needed any convincing at all, that the best thing for Britain is to leave here as soon as possible. It was the way that those elections were conducted yesterday. Because if that is this place's idea of democracy, then that is a serious betrayal of every country that is represented here. Because it is not democratic at all. And that is just one of many reasons why Britain is right to be leaving this place, hopefully, on Halloween. And it is right because there is a pattern consistent throughout history of oppressed people turning on the oppressors, slaves against their owners, the peasantry against the feudal barons, colonies, Mr. Verhofstadt, against their empires. And that is why Britain is leaving. And it doesn't matter which language you use, we are going and we are glad to be going. I represent the southwest of the United Kingdom.
Piano, facciamo concludere.
And I found on my
come to a conclusion, please.
First day that this place has decided, at least this place hasn't, the powers that be have decided to actually increase the size of fishermen's meshes, thereby reducing their income by 40%. That's what you do here. That's why we're going.
Grazie,
news
conclude.
Are long, wir gehen, we're off.
Let me make this very clear, Mr. Sassoli. You have no right to go and speak with the UK Speaker, having conversations that are directly interfering into our domestic politics. It exposes your intentions to intervene at all levels to stop Brexit. It is immoral. Shame on you. Yeah. And Mr. Barnier, I note throughout your speech, sir, I note throughout your speech, you kept referring to the British negotiators as just British. We are the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland, and that will never change. Brexit was not a rejection of Europe or our wonderful European friends. It was a rejection of the anti-democratic nature of EU institutions. And you confirmed to us every day it was right to leave. Thank you.
Yes, that means you, Mr. Barnier. You're not looking for solutions. You're looking to put obstacles in our way. You may have conned a very weak and gullible Mrs. May into signing up into a new treaty from which there was no escape, but you're not conning us. We don't want your treaty in any form, even with Mr. Johnson's proposed amendments. The referendum was very clear. We voted to leave the institutions of the European Union and to be free. And you know, we've had enough of being talked down to by you, insulted by Messrs. Tusk and indeed Juncker. And we will never accept a German Chancellor attempting to annex a part of our nation. We simply won't have it. The good news is your wretched treaty is off the table. Support for a clean break Brexit is growing, and it will be the winning ticket at the next general election. I know you want to ban our national flags, but we're going to wave you goodbye, and we'll look forward in the future to working with you as sovereign.
If you disobey the rules, you get cut off. Could we please remove the flags?
This is it, the final chapter, the end of the road. A 47-year political experiment that the British, frankly, have never been very happy with. My mother and father signed up to a common market, not to a political union, not to flags, anthems, presidents, and now you even want your own army. For me, it's been 27 years of campaigning and over 20 years here in this Parliament. I'm not particularly happy with the agreement we're being asked to vote on tonight, but Boris has been remarkably bold in the last few months. And, Ms von der Leyen, he's made it clear, he's promised us there'll be no level playing field. And on that basis, I wish him every success in the next round of negotiations. I really do. But the most significant point is this. What happens at 11 p.m. this Friday, the 31st of January, 2020, marks the point of no return. Once we've left, we are never coming back, and the rest, frankly, is detail. We're going, we will be gone. And that should be the summit of my own political ambitions. I walked in here, as I've said before, you all thought it was terribly funny. You stopped laughing in 2016. But my view has changed of Europe since I joined. In 2005, I saw the constitution that had been drafted by Giscard and others. I saw it rejected by the French in a referendum. I saw it rejected by the Dutch in a referendum. And I saw you in these institutions ignore them, bring it back as the Lisbon Treaty, and boast you could ram it through without there being referendums. Well, the Irish did have a vote and did say no and were forced to vote again. You're very good at making people vote again, but what we've proved is the British are too big to bully, thank goodness.
They say that you're a runaround lover, though you say it isn't so. But if you put me down for another, I'll know, believe me, I'll know. 'Cause a night has a thousand eyes, and a thousand eyes can't help but see. If you are true to me, so remember when you tell those little white lies that the night has a thousand eyes. You say that you're at home when you phone me, and how much you really care. Though you keep telling me that you're lonely, I'll know if someone is there. 'Cause a night has a thousand eyes, and a thousand eyes can't help but see. If you are true to me, so remember when you tell those little white lies that the night has a thousand eyes. Gonna be sorry, 'cause your game I'm gonna play. And you find out without really trying, each time that my keys astray. 'Cause a night has a thousand eyes, and a thousand eyes will see me through. And no, so remember when you tell those little white lies that the night has a thousand eyes.